Now, Jeffrey Brown talks to a fiction writer as he imagines where the world is heading next.
We're in the future after much of the globe has become an environmental wasteland, and the U.S. is divided into labor settlements where workers toil to produce food and much else. The privileged few live in charter villages, and everyone else inhabits the wild, often violent colonies beyond. A teenage girl named Fawn makes her way through this world, searching for a lost love. The novel is titled On Such a Full Sea, and it's quite a departure for author Chang-rae Lee, whose previous books include Native Speaker and The Surrendered. And welcome to you.
Great to be here.
I read that your original idea was to write a novel of social realism.
Yes.
About Chinese laborers. So how did that evolve into this futuristic story?
Well, I'd gone over to China, to Shenzhen, to the villages there where there are lots of factories, and visited a factory and had this you know, big idea to write this, you know, this broad social novel about workers, owners, you know, all their struggles. But when I got back to my writing desk, I felt as if I didn't have a special angle on the material, that it was going to be good journalism. But I think for novels, you need that extra perspective or other layers of approach that make the story, you know, come alive in a different way. And so I dropped that novel, and at the same time, you know, looking for something else, I came upon a premise about setting a novel in the future.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to set it in the novel in the future because the premise involved bringing over en masse Chinese laborers to the United States, which I knew couldn't happen now, but perhaps could in a very different future.
Well, so they come because of the environment, what happens in China, and they end up in the U.S. There's, of course, a great tradition of writers drawn to this kind of looking at the future, which is sort of like our own, but not quite, right?
Right.
Was it exciting or difficult, or
it was
what grabbed you about it?
It was liberating in one sense, of course, because you have, you know, at your fingertips anything and everything to imagine and think about. The problem, of course, is that sometimes you're trapped by your own premise, mm-hmm. I think that's the fun part about it is to try to defy the premise that you've come up with, and to take it into different directions.
And your past work is more observed of in our time. Here, I guess it was wide open, right?
Yeah, I mean, in my previous novels, I would say are psychologically realistic and
mm-hmm.
very close in views of people who immigrants sometimes, others who are sort of, you know, at a crossroads in terms of how they feel about themselves in their families or in their communities. In some sense, this novel is not that different.
Once you get into it, right?
Once you get into
work
itself is not actually all that radical. What is radical is that once you change the context around these figures, and they're still human beings, of course, once you change that that context or circumstance radically, you realize that things inside change, morality changes. Practices mm-hmm. and beliefs change. And suddenly people are formed and deformed in very interesting ways.
You know, what also you begin to realize, and for me, because on this, we spent a lot of time on this program looking at social issues, obviously, and economic divisions in the society. And then here it's notable that you've created this world of deep divisions, class society, industrial, everything's run down, right? The world is sort of ground down economically, in a sense. So did you have this world in mind as well?
Well, one of the things that I was interested in that original novel about China, set in contemporary times, was Chinese ascendancy. But the flip side of that was a sense of American stagnation and perhaps decline.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the things that I brought over from that original research, the idea that certain trends in our society, both socio and political, were obviously things that I had anxiety about, that I was worried about. And I think all speculative fiction has as its origin point, you know, present concerns. And those concerns, you know, about class entrenchment, about income inequality, about environmental contamination, about healthcare being so precarious in our society, I think those are things that I've been mulling for the last 10, 15 years.
I read, I didn't know this about you, but that before you became a writer, you actually worked on Wall Street for a year.
I did. I had a job.
So right? Something about this is all in the past, right? Thinking about wealth and poverty.
I took a job on Wall Street. I'm glad I did because it was my only really, my one true day job that I ever had. Uh-huh. But that was a job as an immigrant kid from a family who'd struggled to, and worked hard to put me through, a good American education. It was a little payback for that.
Let me ask you one more thing, because I'm curious about your choice of main characters. It's a 16-year-old girl, Fan. Why tell the story through her?
I wanted someone who was an innocent, and a true innocent. And she's probably not a lot like 16-year-olds today. I think she's purer than that, more innocent than that. I wanted someone who could be almost a vessel for the imagination of those who are telling her story. So that she's this sort of elemental force going out into the world, into this adventure. And that we would be drawn by not her psychology or her philosophy or her leadership even, but by her this kind of pure and fierce persistence that she has.
We're not going to give away what happens here, but do you in the end see this as a kind of warning, or did it just become a good story to tell for you?
Well, it in the process of it, I was just enjoying the storytelling. Mm-hmm. I think what begins to accrue and what began to accrue and almost surprised me as I went along was how much of my concerns came out in the book. I never intended to write a political novel, and I don't think I'll ever intend to write a political novel. But perhaps out of all my books, this one is more pointedly looking at issues of our time.
All right. On Such a Full Sea, Chang-rae Lee, thank you so much.
Great to be here.